to Jeff Van Gundy.
Iguodala to inbound. Shumpert trying to stay with Curry. Catches one dribble, steps back, puts up a three. Won't go. Rebound tip taken by Spades. Final seconds. It's over. It's over. Cleveland is a city of champions once again. The Cavaliers are NBA champions. Cleveland's long sports nightmare has ended. The drought is over. 52 years. Time to celebrate a title. And the emotions for LeBron James, who delivers on his promise to come home and bring a championship to his beloved hometown. And of course, the disappointment, the stunning disappointment at the other end. James Jones's longtime teammate, been with him for all six of these consecutive finals. And an emotional Tyronn Lue. What a scene, an emotional scene for LeBron James. These diehard fans, so passionate. They so love their teams. Decades of heartbreak of being teased, but it never diminished their passion. And now they're rewarded with an NBA championship. As always, the terrific sportsmanship. So much more to come here from Oracle Arena as LeBron James and the Cavaliers win the NBA championship. And a celebration just underway in the city of Cleveland. Let's go to Doris.
Mike, overcome with emotion is exactly how I would describe LeBron's reaction as he shares a hug with Kyrie. We'll get in a minute, but he is still crying tears of joy. LeBron.
I'm sorry, Doris.
No worries, Kyrie. LeBron, as soon as that buzzer sounded, your emotions let loose. Can you describe what you're feeling right now?
I set out a goal 2 years when I came back to bring a championship to the city. I gave everything that I had. I poured my heart, my blood, my sweat, my tears to this game, and against all odds, I don't know why we want to take the hardest road. I don't know why the man above gives me the hardest road, but it's nothing the man above don't put you in situations that you can't handle. And I just kept that same positive attitude, like, instead of saying, why me, they're saying this is what he want me to do. And Cleveland, this is for you. Oh,
LeBron, you did what no other team had been able to do, coming back from a 3-1 deficit in the finals. And to do that, you had to win twice in a place that proved too much for so many teams. What did you find in game five here?
Just locked in. I had to change my approach a little bit on how I approached the game. I wasn't that good in the first two games here in this building. I watched a lot of film, detailed it out, changed my blueprint, and was able to put together some spectacular games after being down 3-1. History, we're in the record books. We're the first team ever to come back from a 3-1 deficit. This is special.
We'll see you in a few minutes on the podium, LeBron.
All right, thank
Mike.
You,
thank you, Doris. One of the great storybook endings in all of sports. And it looked like earlier in the finals like it was going to end like so many other seasons for the Cleveland sports teams, with a defeat and a wait till next year. But LeBron James and the Cavaliers win three straight, two here at Oracle Arena. Has there ever been a player more valuable to his team than James has been in Cleveland the last 2 years?
You think about what he was able to accomplish. Coming back to Cleveland, making the statement, taking a team that had been awful the previous 4 years, and flat out got it done. I said before, Mike, this is the greatest individual achievement in the history of this league, what he did.
Those 4 years he was in Miami, Cleveland had the worst record in the NBA during that span. He comes back, back-to-back finals, and a championship season for the city of Cleveland. Final score, Game 7, Cavaliers 93, Warriors 89. We'll be back to Oakland for the trophy presentation. A shocking ending for Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors to lose their last two games at Oracle Arena, the most dominant home court in the NBA over the past 2 years, as they fail to repeat, coming up short in Game 7 against the Cleveland Cavaliers. LeBron James came back home to deliver a championship to his hometown. He fulfilled his promise tonight with a spectacular road performance in the fourth quarter to win the championship. Let's get the ceremonies going right now and go to PA announcer Matt Hurwitz.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to center court for the presentation of the Larry O'Brien Trophy and the 2016 Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award. Please welcome ABC's Doris Burke.
Ladies and gentlemen, with us tonight to present the 2016 NBA Championship Trophy, please welcome NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
You just witnessed one of the greatest games in NBA history. To the Golden State Warriors, congratulations on a historic season. To Joe Lacob, Peter Guber, and Coach Kerr, you're all a class act, and the NBA thanks you. And now, Dan Gilbert, your partners, your family, Coach Lou, and the tremendous Cleveland Cavaliers, congratulations. You're the first team in the history of the NBA to come back from a 3-1 deficit to win the championship. And to Northeast Ohio and Cleveland, the curse is over. The 52-year drought has come to an end. Let me present the championship trophy.
People of Cleveland deserve it more than any people I've ever seen or met or felt. And thank God that God loves Cleveland, Ohio. He does. And I want to thank everybody. Thank David Griffin in the front office, Ty and the coaching staff, everybody in the entire franchise, the best fans in the world, and LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Well, that trophy found an appropriate person to carry it. When LeBron left, in the fashion he did after the first time, could you have ever envisioned him returning and fulfilling this dream?
I couldn't hear you exactly, Doris, but I all I know is that no group deserves this more, no fan base deserves this more, and I'm speechless and proud of everybody. It's like a fantasy for everybody. And thank you, Cleveland. Love you, Cleveland. And thank you to the Golden State Warriors and Joe Lacob, their class act, and it was a great series. Great series. Thank
Congratulations.
You.
Ty Lue. Ty, there was a point at which you were down 3-1, but your confidence never faltered. What was it about the character of this group that you never doubted them?
Just, we've been through adversity all year, and, you know, we went through a lot, and, you know, guys counted us out. You know, they said we couldn't get it done, But it ain't about me. It's about the guys. You know, that, you know, I would go to war with these guys any night, any day. And they stuck with it. And we had a chance to give up, but we made history tonight. And I told these guys, you know, all year we've been making history. Why not tonight? So these guys came out, had a great showing. I'll go to war and battle these guys any single night. And I just want to give a shout out to Mexico, Missouri, and Cleveland, Ohio. We're coming back, baby. Let's go!
Ty, you have played along some of the all-time greats, Shaq, Kobe, Michael. We are witnessing one of the once-in-a-generation players in LeBron James. What makes this man so extraordinarily special?
You know, outside of his basketball talent, that's what you look at when you see on the floor. You see his basketball talent, the way he can control a game and take over a game and things like that. But the biggest thing for LeBron, the reason why he deserves this, is because he has a great heart. And he's always giving. He's giving to everyone. And it's not just about basketball. It's about who he is as a person. And great things happen to great people. So I'm just happy for LeBron. I'm happy for the city of Cleveland, the state of Ohio, the Cleveland Cavaliers organization, and Mexico, Missouri. We in the house, baby.
Two shout-outs for Mexico. Congratulations. Time now to bring back NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to present the MVP award. Adam.
2 years ago, he wrote a letter to his fans in which he said, "I'm coming home." And he said, "Nothing is given to you in Northeast Ohio. Everything is earned." And LeBron, it was unanimous. Most valuable player, 2016 NBA Finals. Congratulations.
That Adam Silver referenced, you said the most important thing to you was to bring a championship to Northeast Ohio. Why was that so important?
I understood what the people of Northeast Ohio have been through the last 50 plus years. I kept it at bay. I never stressed the fact that I didn't feel the pressure, that none of those things. So it always kept me level-headed, but I understood what everyone in Northeast Ohio have been through the last 50 plus years. And I'm happy to be a part of history. I can't wait to get back home. I'm ready to get to you guys.
What kind of character did it require of a group that had so many playing in their first NBA Finals to come out and win on this floor?
We've been through so much adversity these last 2 years. I just knew what we was capable of, even being down 3-1 versus the greatest regular season team ever, you know, 73-9, and everybody counted us out, and that's when we strive the most, when everybody counts us out. And that's definitely when I strive the most, when everybody count me out.
LeBron, you won two titles in Miami, and I know they meant the world to you. Why does this one feel different?
I'm home. This is what I came back for. I'm at a loss for words. This is unbelievable. It doesn't feel real right now.
Congratulations, LeBron.
Thank you, Doris. Thank you so much.
Kyrie Irving, are you around me?
Who are you looking for?
Kyrie.
Hey, what's Kyrie?
Kyrie, a year ago, you were alone in a hospital room watching your team do battle and try to win an NBA championship. Can you describe what it was like for you going to battle and ultimately fulfilling what were childhood dreams, you said?
History was made tonight, but I mean, that championship team that's in that locker room right there, we got to give them a lot of credit. They did an amazing job. And for us, it was just about being resilient and coming in and taking care of business. But I mean, this is one for the books, literally, one for the books.
Down the stretch, though it had been a tough at times, difficult series for Kevin Love, the big three was able to deliver. Why was that?
Just staying aggressive, sticking to the game plan, executing offensively and defensively. But I'm glad all the X's and O's are done and we can celebrate this championship.
Can you describe what it is like playing alongside of LeBron James and what effect he has on this group's ability to be confident that it can win regardless of the circumstance?
Best player on the planet right there. As you can see with the finals MVP, he took us home tonight, and that's what he does. That's what great players do. And he made history tonight, and I'm proud of him.
Congratulations. Tristan Thompson.
Congratulations.
I don't know many guys, Tristan, that would embrace so readily the dirty work that you pursue on a nightly basis. Why? Why are you so able to embrace that role?
Be a star in your role. I like to look at an championship team as a puzzle. Everyone has, you know, the role. Some guys' role is to score, defend, and for me, just do the dirty work and just be a star in your role.
You told us yesterday that your father is responsible for the toughness that you display. It is Father's Day, and he can't be here, but I know he's watching. What would you say to him?
Thank you for everything. Just the toughness, the work ethic he instilled in our family. I love you, Pops.
I would put the same question to you. You are playing alongside a once-in-a-generation player in LeBron James. What makes this man so great?
Like Coach Jackson said, he's a bad, bad man, Doris. Just how he's able to elevate everyone's game and just help us young guys show us what it takes to win a championship.
Congratulations, Tristan, and congratulations to the 2016 NBA champion, Cleveland Cavaliers. Mike.
Thank you, Doris. Well, unless you've lived it in that city, it's difficult to understand the magnitude of the moment for those sports fans, the overwhelming joy, the depth of the emotion. The Cleveland sports fans celebrating right now. And guys, you know you've been a part of this league for a long time. All that goes into a moment like this.
Well, the decisions, not just for LeBron to come to Cleveland, but also management, front office, coaches, these players. Kyrie Irving was spectacular. It's everybody's championship. Even the fans of Cleveland that have gone through so much waiting for this moment, they deserve it.
Absolutely. Everyone knows the Irving jump shot and how great he played, and James. But listen, Kevin Love played big tonight. Shumpert made that four-point play. I mean, everybody has a part, and everybody should be recognized.
And Mark, fans are always a part of it, but I don't know. I mean, there's been certain instances, but these fans, such a part of this. They've been teased and tormented. Years where their teams had no chance. Other years, seasons of great hope, only to end in heartbreak. And now they have their title, their championship, in courtesy of one of their own. Now, SportsCenter is currently on ESPN News with full coverage of Game 7 from here in Oakland and Cleveland. You can tune in for all the post-game reactions and a complete analysis of the final. So much coverage coming up. As LeBron James cradling the NBA championship trophy. And finished off another epic performance in the finals with a triple-double.